Hello, my dear students. In this lesson, we will revise lesson 8, The Great Revolt of 1857. In this lesson, we discussed about many things, causes of revolt, political causes, social and religious causes, then economic causes, military causes, then we discussed about an immediate cause also. And then what was the political causes? Political causes, it is main reason was the land revenue policies of the Britishers. Land revenue policies adopted by the Britishers or land revenue policies angered many chief and landlords by robbing them on their power and privileges. And the Britishers, they conquered territories on the basis of the subsidiary alliance and the doctrine of lapse. This was the political causes for the revolt of 1857. And social and religious causes, the British, they introduced several reforms such as the legalization of widow remarriage to improve the condition of women. Caste norms were violated when people of different castes were thrown together in the army, prisons, railways, etc., etc. Okay, and economic causes. The economic policies of the British, I told you many economic policies are adopted by the Britishers, and these economic policies of the British caused widespread dissatisfaction, widespread distress, and the Indian rulers who lost their power could no longer patronize the traditional Indian crafts, their armies too, they were disbanded, and many artisans and soldiers thus become unemployed. And the many military causes also were there. Many soldiers, many sipois, they were not satisfied because of their salaries and opportunities of promotion were not equal to those of the British soldiers. This was a military cause. And one immediate cause also were there. In 1856, the Enfield rifle was introduced in the company's army, and the soldiers, they were not ready to use the cartridge because they believed that these things are made from the fat of cows and pigs, which their respective religion forbade them to eat. This news spread like wildfire, and in some places sipois refused to use the cartridge. And next we discussed about the revolt at Delhi and end of the Mughal Empire. The revolt at Delhi and the end of the Mughal Empire. On May 1857, the sipahi at Meerut marched to jail, freed their colleagues and massacred the British officers. And here we can see that the Bhakt Khan of Bareilly, who had served in the British army, he led the band of rebels to Delhi. And to suppress the revolt, the British brought in forces from various regions of India, including a large number of newly recruited Sikh sipahis from Punjab. And a terrible massacre followed. The Mughal Empire came to an end. Bahadur was captured, tried, found guilty and deported to Rangoon. Okay, and he died in 1862. And what were the other centers of the revolt? The revolt spread to various regions. It won the support of the dispossessed of nobles and lords, artisans, peasants, etc., etc. After Meerut and Delhi, the revolt spread mainly Kanpur, Lucknow, Jhansi, Gwalior, Bareilly, etc., etc. And in Kanpur, we can see that Nana Sahib, the discontent son of Peshwa Bajirao II, he led the revolt at Kanpur. And in Lucknow, we can see Begum Hasrat Mahal, wife of the deposed ruler Wajid Ali Shah, and in Ara, Kunwar Singh of Jagdishpur led the revolt at Ara in Bihar. And next we can see that Khan Bahadur Khan, he led the revolt at Bareilly. And Jhansi and Gwalior, Dani Lakshmi Bhai joined rebels because her adopted son was denied inheritance of the throne of Jhansi. And next we discussed about the reason for why the revolt failed. The British had support of long, strong government in England. Besides, their administrative centers in India were well connected by railways, roads, telegraph lines, etc., etc. And in contrast, in the Indian military techniques were outdated. That was the main reason for the failure of the revolt of 1857. The Indian military techniques, it was outdated. The British, they used modern weapons, and the Indians, they did not. They used the old methods of war only. And the revolt of 1857 was called the Sipoy Mutiny. The revolt began with the mutiny of the sipois and but soon transformed into a popular revolt when people from different sections of the society spontaneously joined the revolt of 1857. And what was the result of the 1857 result of the revolt of 1857? The revolt marked the end of the East India Company's rule in India. The British crown took over the administration of British Indian territories. That was the important result of 1857 revolt. And once again I will conclude, there were many factors that led to the revolt of 1857. Political causes: displacement of many rulers and landowners, annexation of territory based on the subsidiary alliance and the doctrine of labs. And social causes: Orthodox Indians, they were offended by social reforms and violation of caste norms. Economic causes: land revenue system that brought losses of both landlords and peasants. Then military causes: lower pay and lack of promotional avenue for sepoys. And immediate cause: introduction of the rifle having cartridge allegedly greased with the fat of cows and pigs. This was the main reason for the revolt of 1857. Very easy to understand. Read again and again. If you have any doubt about anything, you can ask through the comments. Okay.